Simulated this contact accidents, patients with compliance with apnea when they go up, simulated driving tests. How is it diagnosed? We have physical examination, history, and sleep studies. There is always disrupted sleep, restless sleep, awakening with gasping and choking, loud snoring, tiredness, inappropriate falling asleep, and witnessed apnea in the compromised organs. Associated complaints, weight gains, and thyroid and other hormone-related disorders, hormonal abnormalities, gastrointestinal reflux, sleep schedule will be always disturbed with alcohol, and habitual alcoholism. Then they have multiple medications for hypertension, sedatives, antihistamines involved. All these patients have to suspect OSA, and this is how the
Yeah. not in being occupied, wherein there were some environmental changes, resulted in changes in the patient which we got to. Article on similar concept has come out, and I am left to be, my thing is obstetric sleep apnea. Now, what is the parallel airway, even despite repeated attempts by the patient? Now, this is associated with snoring, but not all. Now, there is a different percentage of sleep apnea that occurs. In females, it is about 2%, and in males, it is about 4%. The interesting point, understanding, would give us a better insight to manage that.
Now, in obstructive sleep apnea, there are three zones that are important to us.
The nasopharynx, the oropharynx, or the hypopharynx.
Now, the nasopharynx starts from your piriformis fossa up to the level of the ulna.
The oropharynx is from the level of the ulna to your epiglottis, and the hypopharynx from the level of the pharynx is below that. Now, sleep apnea, it is of three types. Central sleep apnea, obstructive sleep apnea, and neurological sleep apnea. Now, central sleep apnea is probably beyond my perspective, and it is more to do with the pulmonologists, the neuro, and the other faculty or the medicine who are associated with it, and it's managed. Now, mixed sleep apnea is a gray area which you need to tread carefully, because part of it will come in the surgeon's hand, and part of it will be in the medical field. Now, the other one, sleep, obstructive sleep apnea, which I am what we will be doing in the future. Now, Dr. Ali has given us a proper insight into all this, and it could be run through here.
Now, not for breathing patterns, type apnea, and apnea where there is total serious now, so
now, the management of obstructive sleep apnea, we can group it under this, the diagnosis. In the diagnosis, we go into the history, physical examination, which is called the oral, and the extraoral parameters, and the evaluation, and the investigation.
Now, in the history, this is a standard format where you take a data set for current instead of comprehensive data. Awakening tests are usually given by the patient attendant. Now, physical examination could have an intraoral and an extraoral exam. When I just go to the anatomical slide, these are the areas of anatomical structures which you need to address in the obstructive sleep apnea. They are the major structures, obstructive tetraedral protein, and large ulna, hypopharynx, oropharynx, hypotrachea, retrobranchium, mitochondria. Next slide is an interesting thing, wherein a size of more than 17 inches would be 43.2 centimeters for male and 40 centimeters for female, would lead to what we call as obstructive sleep apnea. Then obesity, acromegaly, hypertension, diabetes.
All these have been covered by Dr. Ali.
Just a small recap.
Now, these are the intraoral examination in one area which I would like to emphasize on.
So what you see here, you see the upper jaw is normal, the lower jaw is placed behind. And you see that the lower jaw is placed forward, the upper jaw is placed behind.
So just keep this in mind. When I go on to the next slide, I will tell you of interesting classification based on macrocystic surgeons or the treatment concept is based on. So for all of us, there are certain parameters. A normal healthy individual with normal patient profile will have what we call as a class 1 profile. A class 1 profile will indicate the balance of the base along with the abdomen. So in this, there is a specific molar relation, adequate overdepth and overbite. Now there is one photograph which I showed you that the jaw is smaller. It is called as the class 2. Okay? Now in class 2 are the cases where you need to bring them because of obstructive sleep apnea. Having said that, the other associated factors can affect a patient's normal profile who has a perfect class 1 for clinical presentation. It should be because of obesity. Okay? Now this in a normal individual normal class 1 can have an additional narrowing of the airway because of obesity or associated factors. Now, a brief into the evaluation because I will just summarize what Dr. Harin has said because people have come in the EA. Now, evaluation of the obstruction is the simplest thing for children to hear later X-ray. It would give you the size, it will give you the location of the size of your area. The best would be this development rate. If you cost us about 300 rupees in our cost per ton, this would be your development rate. It would give us the position of the town, the and the area. Mudak Manohar is more than by the ENT surgeon that had a word with Dr. Nasir, where you have your center of W scope, and then you see the level of objects, whether it is at the soft palate or at the level of at or beyond the soft palate. So you pinch the bone and it is a manner of your lady. Then CT and MRI. These are advanced diagnostic tools. MRI is probably one of the best for skin study, but it is expensive. This is an MRI which would give you an actual flow of air in the patient. Now, the other thing is what you call as DICE. I think Dr. Ali made a mention of it. With the anesthesia department, you can probably take it up to the workplace in doubt or in a dilemma because it is not one of the better diagnostic tools. The other one is called as summarizing this. Dr. Ali has already told you about respiratory distress index and apnea hypopnea index. Now, there are three levels, mild, moderate, and severe, and these are the ranges of seriousness of respiratory to give you so the mild, moderate, or severe level. Now, American Academy of Sleep Study has laid down a certain criteria wherein you need to address the patient if they show any of these parameters and then you treat it for. Sir, excessive data and sleepiness, two or more of these factors along with this, that is protein, recurrent connecting, underfishing, data particular, repair concentration, and apnea hypopnea index of more than 5. Now, I have done a little search of literature to help me in my presentation, and wherein I have come across this algorithm, where in this study we have, it was a huge data that was available, I summarized it to this to help us understand and treat sleep apnea better, the objective part. The first one is objective sleep apnea as a non-surgical management and a surgical management. The non-surgical management would involve CPAP. And the medical management with the ENT, the maxillofacial and the thoracic are probably treating it. At the level of the nasopharynx, oropharynx, or the laryngopharynx, as per our anatomical guide that we have seen. Now, we just go in and repeat the oral appliance. Now, when do you give an oral appliance? From CPAP, even though it is a very good tool which would increase the flow of air to the patient, we have 5 to 20 milligrams of 20 centimeters of mercury, but there is a lot of set time. Patient reduces them, they cover them, and there is a lot of discomfort to the patient wearing it and going to bed. So in such a scenario, there are what we call as the oral appliances. Now, there are certain principles of taking in the oral appliance. The two basic studies have been done on this, wherein they have used the literature program, MRI, evaluate, and see the soft tissue changes and the dental scale, like Papa mentioned, it is the mandibular advancement and tongue holding devices, and this is more effective for mild sleep apnea. All along it has been the American Association of Sleep Apnea study, but the dental people are not far behind, so they have an association called the Academy of the Sleep Dental Study which has given certain guidelines. So the guidelines are, there is a mild sleep apnea, oral devices can reduce the symptoms up to 76%, and it is moderate. So the oral devices have a role to play in all three levels of sleep apnea based on the AHI or the RDI scale, but it is only marginal. So quickly a treating physician should not go to search and try to pick up one and then try to give it to the patient, because the concept of this oral appliances have basically come from the orthodontics, wherein you set your teeth alignment. In a growing individual, it is called as a myofunctional appliance, where an appliance is given to the patient to hold the jaw in a forward position so that it accentuates the growth of the patient. Now the similar concepts have been transferred to the oral devices, and in the oral devices, what is happening is the whole studies have proven beyond doubt that the patient compliance increases and their scores of AHI and RDI changes markedly. So these are the various appliances. One is the mouth appliance, ear base, nose guard, and the tongue repositioning device. Now, like I said, there are certain criteria that have been laid down in the screen. One of the main criteria for there is a teen center, habits, DMA, generated study, and once the oral appliance is fabricated, the design is customized to individual patient, and after 6 months, the patient is again recalled to check for the fit of the patient, fit of the appliance, and then the polysomnography study is again done. Now, these appliances are progressive, that is, once the appliance is put, I made a mention that the jaw needs to be held in the maximum forward position to have a better compliance or better result. So to hold the jaw in a complete forward position, one time movement of the jaw causes problem of DM. So for this situation, the appliances are so fabricated that they are progressively activated so that the jaw comes to the maximum position without causing any physiological damage to the temporomandibular joint. So that is the reason why custom-made appliances or two users would not be taken. Now, studies have shown that if there is a 50% reduction in the AHI and RTA parameter, the treatment has been successful and the appliance results. Okay? Now, surgical indication. Now, respiratory distress indication is more than 15, daytime sleepiness, saturation less than 16, cardiac arrhythmia, now, this is the area of interest for me. Stanford has given two protocols wherein he said phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 is for mild or the initial state of surgery wherein simple procedures are done, and stage 2 is the second stage or more advanced stage of surgery wherein the jaw osteotomies are performed, provided the first phase has failed to give you adequate results. Now, obstructive sleep apnea, surgical airway management at the level of the nasal pharynx, moving on, arrhythmectomy and pharyngoplasty. Now, the studies have shown that it is not a single area of obstruction that has caused obstructive sleep apnea. It is always multifactorial. The patient should be evaluated properly for all associated obstructions. Now, this procedure is called the arrhythmectomy, and various modalities are there. You can use a laser, you can use a high-frequency radio, high-frequency radio knife, or it is also called as a combinator. Now, the second stage, the second one is the level of oropharynx, which is called the oropharyngeal parenchymal consumption, and it comes in between. The other one is maxillomandibular advancement procedure, and genoplasty. Now, this is the oropharyngeal parenchymal. This procedure is not that bad, but I have been associated with a very good friend of Dr. Adil, one of the pioneers, one of the best persons around to do sleep study, and he did a lot of objective sleep apnea cases. Now, I have done a couple of cases with him, and we work with STAR and in brain. Now, you know what the Ula is when an exercise is, we bring excise along with the tonsil, it is removed and it is stable. Now, for this case, they are using what we call as the ovulator or the radio frequency measure. Because of that, there is less amount of bleeding, the patient's compliance is better, the recovery is faster. Now, the second case of it, when you do a tonsillectomy along with your oroplasty. Now, coming to my favorite thing for the mandibular expansion, actually mandibular expansion. Now, as mentioned earlier, the concept of the dental appliances from the orthodontic being transferred into the patient for preparation of appliances to hold the tongue and the jaw forward. A similar concept from orthodontic surgery where we perform jaw surgeries for prosthetics, that is the lower jaw and upper jaw are moved forward or backward to give a better result to the patient, usually for prosthetics. Now this surgery I have done in the early preparatory work. The patient has what we call as a class 3 profile or a prognathic mandible. Now if you look at it, it is concave. So I have done what we call as a bilateral secondary sleep osteotomy and move the jaw backward. Now why I am telling you? The same concept is again transferred to obstructive sleep apnea. So this is one case where the osteotomy is done, the jaw is moved backward and it is fixed with two plates. Another case, same thing, and then it is corrected. So this is the lateral cephalogram. Now the lateral cephalogram gives us an idea of how much movement has occurred. See, the teeth are anti back progress. Another case. Now, that is a planning and development of upper area surrounding structural gradient subject to three factors. Now, in this article, they have collected around 104 publications, or publications after that they have taken 15, and the 15 they summarized it, and then they found that maxillary mandibular advancement, the reduction of apnea, hyperapnea index, and respiratory distress index, that is AHI and RDI, was 61% to 92% and 80% to 92%. So there is a good compliance by these procedures. Now, how is this done? Now, this is what we call the report one of the two, where it is done at a higher level, the jaw is advanced forward. The other slide that I showed you is called the bilateral secondary osteotomy, wherein the jaw is moved forward and the genome comes, wherein the chin is moved forward. So what happened? If you have looked at the anatomy slide that I showed earlier, now in the philosophy of automatic surgery, some tissues move along with bone. Now, the proportion of movement is 1:1 in bone and soft tissue, and you don't have to worry about it. But the similar concept when it comes here, when the jaw is advanced, the soft tissue moves forward, the hyoid bone position changes, the muscle position changes, and then there is an increase in the airway pattern. Now what we do is we transfer, we make a mold, we transfer it from towards one of the panavartic letters, wherein the similar jaw position is transferred in, and a spring is made. The study is done using the literature program, the amount of weight that is required, movement that is required, and this is the virtual planning that is done for 3D. We make the data to certain companies, which provide us with the various treatment modalities. We tell them we want to move the upper jaw by 9 mm, the lower jaw forward by 5 mm. They virtually move the whole thing, and then they give us a split. This is a split. So you make the cuts, you put the split inside, and then you have the result wherein the area would increase, and then this would not disfigure the face of the patient, because if the patient is class 2, you do an advancement, it is all okay. But if it is class 1, he has a perfect profile, because of obesity, you do an advancement, the patient's profile changes, which is unacceptable to the patient. So for that reason, you need to balance the amount of advancement by doing the dual jaw surgery. Now, the jaw movements have caused increase in the airway space, and this from the literature supports our argument, and this shows a clear increase in the volume of the air entering it, and the length and the diameter of the cross-sectional also happens, right? This shows a cross-sectional increase in the diameter of the airway based on the osteotomy that has been performed. Now, this is the procedure that I do with what you call as the BSSO, where a cut is made on the inner side of the mandible, and this is the cut on the inner side of the mandible. And then based on the amount of movement that is required, I would end the buckle cut at ABC or level, and then move the jaw to the distance that I want. There is a small video, I am not ready to have time. Now, this is the genoplasty, where osteotomize and move the chin forward. Because of attachment of the genoplasty and genohyoid muscle, the hyoid bone is pulled forward. Along with the movement of the hyoid bone, there is an increase in the coroparenchymal area or the airway. So this is a very simple procedure. This is the case where I have osteotomized, and that is the chin, which is in the reverse direction. And then this is the case. Now this is again an aesthetic surgery that I have done. If you look at it, you see the mandibular part. The chin is the rectangle, the chin is not prominent. This is the profile, this is the nature of the chin. And then I have advanced the chin properly, and this is the portion. This is the portion. Now when you do this procedure, it's a very simple procedure, where you osteotomize and move the chin forward. So the genohyoid muscles that are attached here would move the hyoid bone forward and upward, and that would increase your area. Having said that, had it gone before. Now if it was the story was so simple, not at an excellent result and with a match made in of work. But then I told you in the first slide that there are three types of apnea, and I said there is gray area, which is that is the overlap of both. So when there is overlap of the obstructive and the neurological. When there is an overlap, the gray area, even though you do an obstructive to move the jaw forward, the results would not show still because the patient has a neurological So you need to address the failure for your problem. So this article summarizes and gives us the same information. A management of object state which is communicated directly to our professor and the pediatric department. Now in class, in our class to provide the calling newborn patient, pediatric patient from 3 to 5 years of age, they have what you call as small minor apraxia. In these cases, you can do what you call as a distraction osteogenesis. Now this is one case, now these are all anaphylaxis cases where it is violent apraxia, the patient presents in what you call as a bird basis. This is a case of ankylosis, but this is a typical case where you have a small jaw. Now this is what this procedure is called as distraction osteogenesis, wherein an osteotomy is performed, the jaw is moved forward using your distractor. Now this is the case that I have performed. It is unlike the orthopedic department wherein the long bones are elongated using the Esra technique. Here in the mandible you have what you call as the inferior abdomen. So you can't cut the jaw through and through unlike an osteotomy. You tap it split open and then you put your distractor, and this distractor is activated if you move the jaw in a downward and forward direction based on the vector. Now these cases are done well and a lot of patients require these procedures. This was a case that I have done in another room. So the jaw moves forward. This I have taken it from one of the textbooks wherein they have used the distractor. Move the jaw forward and along with that they have performed the reverse for osteotomy and move the upper jaw also forward to compensate for the failure deficiency. Now to summarize what I have just told, the treatment modalities will involve behavior, positive pressure, the CPAP, jaw transposition by the appliances and surgery. Behavior would be weight loss, alcohol, avoid cheap preparation, deep respiratory function, stop smoking. Now the three levels of the obstruction that are type 1, type 2, type 3, it is at the level of the nasopharynx, so you can use these procedures, nasal reconstruction, respiratory pyrophoplasty, septoplasty, type 2, otolaryngoplasty, tonsillectomy, mandibular maxillomandibular advancement, and third one is iatrogenic surgery or tracheostomy. So these are the questions.
Assalamu alaikum, my Dr. M. Abdul Majid Adil, Superintendent Asra Hospital, part of OBSG group of hospitals. को इस बात की खुशी है आज कि हमारे यहाँ पे एक प्रोग्राम कंडक्ट किया गया, एक प्रेजेंटेशन था जिसमें डॉक्टर अलीमुद्दीन नवीद पल्मोनोलॉजिस्ट असरा हॉस्पिटल और डॉक्टर पद्मरायलू ओरोमैक्सिलोफेशियल असरा हॉस्पिटल की तरफ से एक बहुत खूबसूरत प्रेजेंटेशन किए गए, जिसमें मेन उसका टेक होम मैसेज ये था कि जो है जिसको भी स्लीप प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, जैसे कि नींद में गुर्राटे लेना, नींद में सांस बंद होने की इम्कानात हो, इनको एक मेडिकल ओपिनियन लेना काफ़ी ज़रूरी है और چونکہ اسے سلیپ آبسٹرکٹیو سلیپ اپنیا کہا جاتا ہے اور اس کی وجہ سے میجر پرابلمس ہوتے ہیں ہو سکتے ہیں کمپلیکیشنز جیسے لنگز میں اور رائٹ سائڈ ہارٹ میں ہارٹ فیلئر کے پرابلمس بھی پاسیبل ہیں اور جس کے ٹریٹمنٹس لیٹر سٹیجز پہ کافی مشکل ہو جاتے ہیں تو یہ میسج ہماری ہاسپٹل سے سب کو ہے کہ جو ہے اگر سے سلیپ ڈیزارڈرز ہیں نیند کے پرابلمس ہے زیادہ غراٹوں کے پرابلمس ہے تو اس کا میڈیکل اوپینین لینا کافی ضروری ہے اور اس کو شروعات میں ہی اس کو ٹریٹ کرنا بہتر ہوگا اور میری یہ بھی خواہش ہے کہ اگر سے کچھ پیشنٹس ایسے ایکسپیرئنس کر رہے ہیں تو ہمارے ہاسپٹل میں ان سروسز کی یوٹیلائزیشن اور ان سروسز کا فائدہ اٹھائیں میں شکر گزار ہوں ہمارے چیئرمین جناب اسد الدین اویسی صاحب کا اور ہمارے مینیجنگ ڈائریکٹر جناب اکبر الدین اویسی صاحب کا کہ اس طریقے کے پرابلمس کے پروگرامز جو ہیں اسے انکریج کیا جاتا ہے اور اس سے سارے ڈاکٹرز کو اپنی پریکٹس میں اور پیشنٹس کو فائدہ ہو تھینک یو سو مچ
ڈاکٹر صاحب یہ اور ایک بات یہ تھی کہ اس کے سمٹمس کیا ہے جو غراٹے لوگ اکثر کہتے ہیں کہ جو ہے تھکاوٹ سے جو ہے غراٹے آتے ہیں اس کے سمٹمس
ہاں یہ غراٹوں کے کئی وجہ ہیں ڈاکٹر علیم کا کمنٹ میں چاہوں گا اس بارے میں سلیپ کے بارے میں ڈاکٹر علیم
بہت سارے وقت جو ہے نا غراٹے آتے ہیں بہت زیادہ اوبیسٹی کی وجہ سے موٹاپے کی وجہ سے آتے ہیں کافی لوگ جو زیادہ تھک جاتے ہیں ان کو جلدی غراٹے شروع ہو جاتے ہیں مگر ایسا ضروری نہیں ہے کہ غراٹوں کا ریزن صرف اور صرف تھکان ہے غراٹوں کے کئی ریزن ہے اور اس کا کئی وجوہات ہے اس کے واسطے آپ کو ڈاکٹر سے ملنا کافی ضروری ہے
صاحب یہ بھی ہے کہ جو لوگ چتے لیٹنے سے جو غراٹے کروٹ کر لیتے ہیں اس کا کیا وجہ کیا کیسے کم ہوتا ہے
جی جو وہ جو ہے نا ٹیمپرریلی ٹریٹمنٹ ہے جو آپ چیتے ریٹ کے لیٹنے سے خراٹے آ رہے ہیں اور اگر آپ سیدھے لیٹ جائیں اگر آپ کو امپرومنٹ آ گیا بیٹر دکھ رہا تو وہ ٹیمپرری امپرومنٹ ہے مگر آپ ہر بار سیدھے ایک سائڈ نہیں سو سکتے آپ کو چاہیے کہ اس کے واسطے آپ ڈاکٹر سے
آنے کے سمٹمس کیا ہے کیسا آتا ہے
یہ خراٹے آتے ہیں خراٹے آنے کی وجہ سے کافی کمپلیکیشنز ہوتی ہے وہ بول سکتے ہیں ہم خراٹوں کا موسٹ کامن سب سے کامن ریزن ہے موٹاپا تو ایک بار موٹاپا آ گیا آدمی کو تو اس کی وجہ سے خراٹے آتے ہیں تو خراٹوں کی وجہ سے رات تمام نیند ڈسٹرب ہوتی اگر آپ رات میں نہیں سوئیں گے برابر تو آپ کو دوسرے دن جو ہے نا آپ کی طبیعت تھکان میں رہیں گی آپ کا بی پی بڑھا ہوا رہے گا شوگر بڑھا ہوا رہے گا اگر آپ بی پی شوگر آپ کو آلریڈی ہے تو وہ جلدی کنٹرول میں نہیں آئیں گا جس کے واسطے آپ کو ایک گولی سے ٹریٹمنٹ ہو سکتا ہے اس کے واسطے آپ کو تین تین گولیاں چار چار گولیاں لینا پڑیں گا تو اگر آپ رات کا ٹریٹمنٹ بھی کریں گے سلیپ کا بھی ٹریٹمنٹ کریں گے تو آپ کے ڈائبٹیز کے اور ہائپر ٹینشن کے جو نمبر آف ڈرگس ہے وہ کم ہو جائیں گے ختم نہیں ہوئے تو کم سے کم تین کی جگہ ایک گولی پہ آ جائیں گے آپ تو اس لیے رات کا آپ کے واسطے رات میں جو پرابلمس ہو رہے ہیں اس کا ٹریٹمنٹ کرنا بھی کافی ضروری ہے
شکریہ سر
یہاں پہ سلیپ کی کافی امپورٹنس ہمارے سلیپ میڈیسن میں دی جا رہی ہے آج کل ہمارے یہاں پہ ایک سلیپ لیگ بھی اکوائر کیا گیا تھا جو آلموسٹ اے ایئر بیک جس سے کافی لوگوں کے ٹیسٹس ہوئے اور ان کو اس سے اس سلیپ لیب کے ریزلٹس اور رپورٹس کے بیسس پہ ٹریٹمنٹ کیا گیا ہمارے پاس پلمنالوجسٹ موجود ہیں 24/7 24 گھنٹے کرٹیکل کیئر اسپیشلسٹ موجود ہیں اور پورا ڈپارٹمنٹ آف پلمنالوجی جو سپریٹ ڈپارٹمنٹ ہے یہ پوری طریقے سے سلیپ اسٹڈی کو اور سلیپ پرابلمس سے ٹیکل کرتا ہے تو اس کا فائدہ ہمارے یہاں کے لوکل لوگوں کو یہ ہماری خواہش ہے
یہ کتنے دن کا ٹریٹمنٹ رہے گا
نہیں یہ تو اس کے ملٹی موڈیلٹی ٹریٹمنٹ ہے پہلے تو میڈیسن سے اس کے بعد جو ہے ماسکس آتے ہیں مختلف قسم کے وہ پہن سکتے ہیں لوگ اور پھر ویٹ لاس بہت زیادہ ضروری ہے پر اینڈ میں اگر سے اس سے ٹھیک نہیں رہا تو سرجیکل آپشنز بھی اویلیبل ہے جس سے ہمارے اوروماگزیلوفیشل کی ٹیم ہے ہماری بہت ایکسپیرینسڈ ENT ایئر نوز اینڈ تھروٹ کی ٹیم ہے یہ لوگ ٹیکل کرتے ہیں